Meghan Markle security bill, who has been paying for Meghan and Harry in Canada. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry have been staying in Canada since January, but who has been paying for the couple's security? Meghan, Duchess of Sussex, and Prince Harry have been living in Canada since their bombshell announcement stating they were exiting their senior royal roles. The royal family have been undertaking in-depth discussions on the Sussex's future ever since, and now more has come to light about the logistics of their move. Who has been paying for Meghan and Harry in Canada? The Royal Canadian Mounted Police have been assisting London's Metropolitan Police with security for the Duke and Duchess of Sussex intermittently since November, when the couple began a six-week holiday in Canada, according to a statement from the Federal Office of the Minister of Public Safety. However, once Harry and Meghan are no longer considered senior members of the British royal family, they will no longer receive the publicly funded security which is estimated to cost into the millions of dollars. According to CBS News, Public Safety Canada has confirmed Canada has been providing security for the couple. However, the Government of Canada intends to stop contributing to those costs in the coming weeks, according to the Office of Public Safety Minister Bill Blair. A statement to CBC News on Thursday morning reads in full, "The Duke and Duchess of Sussex choosing to relocate to Canada on a part-time basis presented our government with a unique and unprecedented set of circumstances." The RCMP has been engaged with officials in the UK from the very beginning regarding security considerations. As the Duke and Duchess are currently recognized as internationally protected persons, Canada has an obligation to provide security assistance on an as-needed basis. At the request of the Metropolitan Police, the RCMP has been providing assistance to the Met since the arrival of the Duke and Duchess to Canada intermittently since November 2019. The assistance will cease in the coming weeks, in keeping with their change in status. Meghan and Harry will no longer be known as senior royals come March 31, 2020. The couple will drop their His and Her Royal Highness titles, and no longer undertake royal engagements. On Thursday, March 5, the couple will make their first joint appearance since they announced their intentions to leave the royal family. Harry and Meghan will attend the annual Endeavour Fund Awards at Mansion House in London. This is to honour sick and injured military who have taken part in sporting and adventure challenges across the past year. Their final royal engagement is on Monday, March 9, when they will attend Commonwealth Day celebrations. The couple have reportedly been asked to attend the annual Commonwealth Day service at Westminster Abbey by the Queen. The latest revelation around the Sussex's security comes after it was announced the couple would no longer be using their Sussex royal brand come April. A spokesman for the couple said it had been agreed the word royal could no longer be used due to government rules. This means the Sussex's social media, website and charitable foundation will have to be rebranded after March 31. A spokesperson for the Sussexes said they were focused on plans to create their new organization in the spring. However, Meghan and Harry have agreed not to name it the Sussex Royal Foundation. The couple also revealed they had withdrawn several applications for trademarks for their Sussex Royal brand. A spokeswoman for the Sussexes said, "While the Duke and Duchess are focused on plans to establish a new non-profit organization, given the specific UK government rules surrounding use of the word royal, it has been therefore agreed that their non-profit organization, when it is announced this spring, will not be named Sussex Royal Foundation." The Duke and Duchess of Sussex do not intend to use Sussex Royal in any territory post-spring 2020.